Praise the Lord. Quickly, as we begin, I have dubbed my service, "Where is my mantle?" But my teaching for this morning is, "My heavens must open the mantle of victory." Say, "My heavens must open the mantle of victory." My heavens must open the mantle of victory. Wave your mantle. My heavens must open. I have the mantle of victory. So when they say, "Where is your mantle?" you say, "I have my mantle of victory." Praise the Lord. Where is your mantle? Where is your mantle? Praise the Lord. Book of Deuteronomy, destroy your enemy, 28 verse 12. The Bible says, "The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, thy heaven, to give the rain unto thy land in his what? In his season." The Lord shall open unto his good treasure, thy heaven, to give the rain in his what? Rain into thy land in his what? In his season. This is what open heavens is about. Receiving rain in your due season. When you want a breakthrough now, then the breakthrough happens. That is your what? Open heavens. That testimony I was sharing, if the Lord had not intervened immediately, it would have been what? History. So when we are talking about open heavens, we are talking about things happening for you now, when you want them now. When you want to pay for a car, when must the money come? Now. When you want to pay for your bond, when must the money come? Now. When you want business, when must that business come? Now. When you are sick in your body, when must that healing come? Now. That is, when heavens are opened, it means whatever you ask, you receive instantly. This is why we are saying, this is your month of open heavens. It is when you ask, you receive immediately. When you ask, you receive without stress. When you ask, you receive without worry. Most of us, we have been singing this song, "There shall be showers of blessing, there shall be showers of blessing." But for most of us, it looks like those showers are not coming. We have sung it, put in different melodies, put in different tunes, but it looks like the showers are not coming. Not even the dew from the ground is coming. And we have been wondering what is happening. Because when blessings come in life, it is one of the greater signs that heavens have what are open for you. When things are not working, they say, "Kimatafela," it's a problem all over. Anything you are touching is not working. Anything you do, it doesn't seem to work. When you pray, you don't receive any answer. It's not happening. That should tell you that there is something which is happening in your life. The Bible says, "I will make the heavens of brass and of iron." That means that if things are not happening for you, the heavens are shut. But good news this morning. I say good news this morning. Because the Bible says, when the heavens are shut and there is no rain, when you shall pray towards my holy temple, I shall answer. So this morning, the Lord is set to answer for you. Praise the Lord. Wherever your heavens has been shut, the Lord is set to open them for you. As you pray this morning, as you hear the word this morning, every shut heaven is set to open for you in the name of Jesus. When things are not working, That's when you begin to wonder, Father, am I Christian? Am I actually serving you? You begin to ask God questions. Why is this thing not working for me? Am I not even in the worship team? Am I not serving in technical? Father, am I not paying my tithe? Am I not giving offerings? Am I not fasting? Am I not praying? And it looks like it's not working. There is one thing you need to do. The Bible says you shall declare a word and it shall what? It shall be established. How do you do that? It's very plain. It's very simple. My heavens must open. Say it. For my finances. For my business. For my career. For my family. For my marriage. For my ministry. My heavens must open. Because the Bible says you shall eat the fruit of your lips. What you declare is what happens to you. If you are quiet, nothing happens. Don't assume God knows. Yes, God knows. Don't assume what? God knows. Yes, God knows. But until you speak it, until you declare it, God is not obliged to do it for you. When things are not working, God is not obliged to do it for you until you what? You declare it. Praise the Lord. It says, God is not obliged. Say it after me. God is not obliged. He is not forced to do it for me until I ask. Praise the Lord. Let me quickly tell you, it is not by your crying. God, it is not by what? By your crying. It is not always by faith either that you can get breakthrough or you can get heavens. Get me very right. Praise the Lord. It is not always, sometimes even by warfare prayer. Praise Master Jesus. It is not always by even by your confession or your profession, not by your declaration, but by something simple as a mantle. Praise Master Jesus. This is why this service, it is a special mantle service. In the book of Mark, Mark chapter 5, we know the story of the woman with the issue of blood. That woman says, if only I can touch the hem of his garment. If only I can what? I can touch. So this morning, if you want power to break forth, desire a touch of the mantle. Desire a touch of the Holy Spirit. Desire a touch of the Master. And as you touch him this morning, every sickness that has ravaged your life, it is giving way in the name of Jesus. Every hardship that has faced your life, it is giving way in the name of Jesus. Says, if only I can what? I can touch. What am I saying? It depends on your connection. It depends with your connectivity. It depends with your intimacy with the Master, that is with Jesus Christ. That mantle, that handkerchief, that cloth, that material that you have, it is just a handkerchief. It is just a material to most people. But after prayer this morning, is turning into a power instrument in the name of Jesus. This year has been declared our year of royalty. After the prayer this morning, this is your staff of office. Wherever you shall wave it, doors shall open. Wherever you shall wave it, doors shall open. When you lay it upon the sick, they shall be healed. When you go for an interview, take for example, you cannot be ministering blood of Jesus anointing. People would think you are doing Sangoma Muti stuff here. But if I take off my handkerchief nicely and quiet, and I just dab my face like this, suddenly, that man who has been having a stain Stand looking, angry face, you suddenly see him smiling, all by the power of the Holy Ghost, all by the power in the mantle. This morning, you are contacting that power in the name of Jesus. This morning, you are receiving that power in the name of Jesus. I said it is by a touch of an anointing. It is by your expectation that you conduct this power. And it is also by your what? By your faith. He says, believe that he is able to deliver that power to you this morning. Praise the Lord. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 20. The Bible says, the kingdom of God is not just what? In word, but in what? In power. Somebody say power this morning. Somebody say power this morning. Because we may preach the word, you may declare the word, you may confess the word, but when there is no power to back up that word, the end result is frustration. This is why God, in his manifest wisdom, he has decided to give believers instruments of power. And one of those instruments is the mantle. Praise Master Jesus. Say, instrument of power. Staff of office. Praise the Lord. When we are talking about open heavens, it means there is also closed heavens. Praise the Lord. But what is closed heavens, so that you can understand what open heavens is? Remember, the heavens can be shut either by God himself, by the enemy, or by yourself. Your heavens can be shut by what? By God, by yourself, and sometimes by the enemy. But this morning, good news. When I describe closed heavens, I'll give you a simple scenario. How many people have seen a dam wall where there is a big river, then they build a wall there? How many people have seen a dam wall? That is a very good example of what closed heavens is. Because without that wall or that demarcation, there is flow. But once you build a wall there, it means you stop all the water this side or that side, and it cannot pass through. It means for every believer, there is a river that flows, a river of blessings, a river of healing, a river of breakthrough. But there is something that places a demarcation or a barrier in your river. When there is a demarcation or a barrier, that is closed heavens. But for the believer, there is good news. Because God, in his manifest wisdom, he has created some floodgates. When the flow becomes too much, God opens the floodgates of heaven and the blessings flow. Praise the Lord. So when we are declaring open heavens, you must understand that you need to make the floodgates of heaven to open. And how do you do that? I will shortly come to it. Praise the Lord. He said, my heavens must open. Why must my heavens open? Because in this month, it is our month of remembrance. It is our season of what? Of breakthrough. The Bible says, God, whenever you ask for your heavens to open, number one, he says, put me into remembrance. Number two, he tells you, give me a good reason why your heavens must open. Praise the Lord. Now, quickly, what is the assurance that your heavens are opening for you in this month of April? If you go to Numbers 23, verse 19, the Bible says God is not a what? A man that he should what? He should lie. Neither is he a son of man that he should repent. As he said it, shall he not do it? Praise the Lord. So every time God declares something, it is said to happen for you in the name of Jesus. And to everyone under the sound of my voice this morning, the Lord is set to open the heavens for you. Amen. What is the assurance? Isaiah 55 verse 11, another popular scripture. The Bible says, so shall my word that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void. Praise the Lord. Every time the Lord sent forth a word, it means it must return with something. If the Lord says it's your season of breakthrough, it means there must be something. Either there must be a car, there must be a house, there must be business, there must be finance, there must be marriage. Because when he says, when my word goes forth, it shall not return void. It means in this season, if you are truly tuned to what God is doing in the life of this ministry, it is your season of open heavens. It is your season of an open check. Whatever you desire, whatever you want, whatever you ask, the Lord is saying unto you, it is your season, it is your time. Whatever you ask in the name of Jesus, in this month, you are set to receive it. You are set to receive it because it's your season. This is the assurance that we have. Because God says, my word, when it goes forth, it does not return unto me void. It does not what? Return unto me void. The Bible says the word of God is what? It's yea and amen. So whenever God declares something, it means it must what? It must happen. But also, quickly, because I know amongst us there are doubting Thomases. They will say, was it not Pastor Tau who declared that? Yes, it was him. Praise the Lord. And even if it was not God speaking, I say even if it was not what? God speaking. But because he is a servant of the Lord, because he is a messenger of the Lord, that open heaven is still set to happen for you. This is the assurance that you have. Pastor Nick, you are talking hearsay now. I am speaking scripture. Praise the Lord. Isaiah 44 verse 26. He says, that confirms the word of his servant. Underline the word servant there. And performs the counsel of his messengers. It means if that word, even if it was not God that said it's your season of open heavens, because a servant of God, an ordained servant of God, he has declared it, God is set to perform it in your life. I said God is set to perform it in your life. Because I stand here in the shoes of a prophet, and as I declare it unto you, because I am an ordained servant, whatever I shall declare unto your life, if I declare prosperity into your life today, it shall happen in the name of Jesus. If I declare healing unto you today, it shall happen in the name of Jesus. Right now, receive your healing in the name of Jesus. Receive your breakthroughs. Receive your success. Receive your business. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Take it right now. Whatever you have been asking of the Lord, your healing, receive it. Your business breakthrough, receive it. Your academic success, receive it. Take it right now. Take it, take it, take it, take it, take it. Receive it, receive it. Declare, I receive it. I take it, I take it, I take it. I take it, I take it. I take my business. I take my healing. I take my breakthrough. Take it in the name of Jesus. By a prophet, Israel was led out of captivity. By a prophet were they established. This morning, you are set to be established in the name of Jesus. This morning, you are set to go free in the name of Jesus. Praise Master Jesus. They say 2016 is a year of royalty. And you have been wondering, why is it not happening for me? You have been wondering, because when we are talking about royalty, it means there's what? There's prosperity. But good news to someone this morning. Say, God punish them. Say, God punish them. Every enemy of my life, God punish them. every adversary, God punish them. Indeed, the Lord is going to punish every adversary. Because the Bible says a great and effectual door has been opened for you. Because 2016 is not like any other year. It's a year of rulership. It's a year of splendor. A year of dominion. A year of power. A year of authority. Receive that power in the name of Jesus. Receive that authority. Why am I saying all these things? Because God has been so wonderful. When we started January, it was our month of early dangerous break blessings. And Jesus, the word was saying in the first month in book of Joel, says whatever you have lost in the years past, it was recovery. Then God was finished with us. Came February, we said it's our month of celebration. You shall be celebrated. How is that possible? Because Hosea chapter 6 verse 2, it says in the second day, there shall be what? A raising up. In the second month, the Lord raised this up for a what? For celebration. But still, the devil was saying, And come March, the month of marching forward. You thought finally I am marching forward. But that devil, that old enemy, that Pharaoh, he said, I will withstand you. But the Lord in his wisdom, he said, it's our month of total victories. He says, every Pharaoh must die. And indeed, every Pharaoh died. But then when your Pharaoh dies, there is something that breaks forth. Amen. Because your Pharaoh has stood as that dam wall, as that barrier to close your heavens. But when that Pharaoh dies, it means there is a beginning of something new. Praise the Lord. It means there is a beginning of something new. Do something new in my life. Something new in my life. Something new in my life. Oh, do something.
Do something new. In my life,
something new.
In my life,
something new.
In my life,
the Lord is set to do something new in your life. Because in this fourth month, the month of open heavens, because every Pharaoh has died, he has restored unto you. You are ready for celebration. Something new is set to break forth. Because the fourth day, according to the Bible, signifies the beginning of seasons and times. It means it's your beginning of your seasons. Where you have been defeated before, you are turning into a champion. Where you have been sick before, you are turning into healthy. Where you have struggled before, you are getting victorious. Because the Bible in the book of Genesis, he says on the fourth day, he says, let there be lights in the firmament of heaven. The great light to rule by the day. The weaker light to rule by the night. And I prophesy and I decree in your life, let there be lights. I declare, let there be light. Let your seasons of breakthrough begin. Let the light of the Lord shine. Let the glory of the Lord shine. It's your season, your beginning of seasons in the name of Jesus. That's Genesis chapter 1, verse 14 to verse 19. It says, they shall mark the beginning of seasons. So this is why God has declared this month of April our month of heavens. Because it marks our beginning of what? Of favor. Praise the Lord. You will quickly see how is this possible. Praise the Lord. Hosea chapter 12, 13. By a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet was he what? Was he preserved. This morning, heaven is set to punish every enemy of your life. Because by a prophet, you are set to go free. As the servant of the Lord comes to minister on your mantle this morning, you are going to conduct power And as you go home this morning, every enemy of your life is giving way. Praise Master Jesus. I said earlier on, God has given us as believers instruments of power or a staff of office. Some of them, but not all of them, is prophetic declarations. I said earlier on, when a man of God declares in the name of the Lord, God is too embarrassed not to do it for you because of the name of his servant. Hallelujah. I said, God is too embarrassed not to do it for you because of what? Of his ordained servant. If a man of God declares it, this is a year of marriage, grab it and run with it. I tell you what, grab it and run with it. Give your neighbor a Holy Ghost slap if he's sleeping. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Because I can see some people that the Holy Ghost wants to take away their blessing. Hallelujah. Because, let me digress a little bit. The woman of God in the call to worship, she says, if you shall see me when I go, this thing shall happen to you. Amen. But if you are sleeping during the service, it means you cannot see what the angels are delivering. Hallelujah. So never ever sleep in the service. If you are feeling like sleeping, stand up. Hallelujah. You are free to stand up. You are free to shout, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Even if I am saying, Jesus says, shut up. You say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Tell your neighbor, I shall never sleep again. I shall never sleep again. Amen. Because you know why? Most people, they want fire service. But sometimes it's not about fire. Sometimes we must also deliver the word that you must listen to. Because it is by a word that you can break through in life. It is by what? By a word. And I'm saying it is by prophetic declaration. A word that goes forth that you can break through. Praise the Lord. Every time a man of God declares, be very careful. Hallelujah. Be what? Be what? And some of us, the things we say, our words, be very careful. Slap your neighbor, tell neighbor, wake up. Tell your neighbor, wake up. The power of the Lord is here. The spirit of the Lord is here. Amen. Praise Master Jesus. I said, be careful of declarations. The book of 2 Kings talks about this story of Elisha as he was going forth after receiving power. Say power. Say power. Some little children, innocent little children. I would say rascal children, eh? Let me change innocent to rascal children, eh? It's okay, eh? Uh-huh. They decided to say, go up, you bald head. Go up, you bald head. Like some of us do when we see certain men of God. Eh? We say all manner of things. Although sometimes we might not say it loudly, but we still say it. Eh? Familiarity. Praise the Lord. But then he says, when Elisha turned, when he turned after receiving power, what happened? He says, he cursed them in the name of the Lord. And immediately bears came out and tore the children to shreds. This morning, by that mantle in your hand, whosoever you shall kiss, I say whosoever you shall kiss, whosoever you shall kiss, bears are coming out this morning. Bears are coming out this morning. Begin to cast that spirit of poverty. Begin to curse that sickness. Begin to curse that disease. Begin to curse delay. Begin to curse black and white. By that mantle in your head, declare it, declare it. There is power. There is power in that mantle. Curse that sickness. Curse that poverty. Declare it right now. Declare it right now. Declare it right now. In the precious, mighty name of Jesus. He cursed them in the name of the Lord. So whatsoever you shall curse in this season in the name of the Lord, it shall give way in the name of Jesus. I don't care whether that problem He has been there for ages. I don't care whether it has been there for generations. I don't care. They say no one succeeds in your family. This morning, as you cast it in the name of the Lord, it shall give way in the name of Jesus. It is giving way in the name of Jesus. Praise Master Jesus. Power instruments in staff of office. That is called the believer's authority. What you have as a believer. I said prophetic declaration, your words, your utterance. The blood of Jesus. We know the Bible says it speaks greater and better things. Every time you declare, every time you use, there is no devil that can withstand the blood of Jesus. Amen. Number three, communion. When you partake communion, you partake and you conduct the very essence of God. That's power instrument that you have been given. Number three. Number four, your hand and feet washing. Some people, they do feet washing only. I blame them. It is the understanding and the revelation God has given them. But according to the book of Exodus, it says you shall wash your hands and your feet, that you shall die not. So anytime you come into a feet and hand washing service, it means God is giving you another power instrument of overcoming. Praise the Lord. Number five, stones. I know people from Zimbabwe, when you start talking about stones, immediately they talk of the white garment apostles. Of Madzibabas and the Madzimais. No, stones is from the Bible. Is the revelation, is the understanding. He says David, when he went to face Goliath, he took five stones from the brook of the river, and one of it killed Goliath. So when you apply a stone, it means you are being what? Biblical. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What else does the Bible say about that stones? In the book of Joshua, Joshua chapter 4. You know why I am not giving you specific verses today? Because I know some of you, when we give you verses, this is the last you write about it. You don't even read it. So when they put it on the screen, then thank God it's done. I have read it. So you go and read it in Joshua chapter 4. God says you shall do this as a memorial for your what? For your generations. So when somebody uses a stone, when they pray for a stone, it is that revelation, it is that understanding that that stone has become a stone of offense against your enemies. Praise the Lord. That is, I said David took five stones and it was also number five on my list. Amen. Number six, anointing water, anointing oil. And we all are familiar about this one. But where we are going today, the mantle. Say the mantle. The mantle. You know, people of God, I was praying. God, show me about the mantle. God, show me. Teach me about the mantle. And I can tell you, I have gone through so many services. And I have did not grasp really what it was about. I knew about the story of Elijah and Elisha. Give your neighbor a Holy Ghost slap if he's sleeping. Say, neighbor. If you miss that man, when he delivers that word, you are not getting it. But if you shall see him, when he delivers that word, say double anointing. Say double power. Say double glory. Say double open heaven. Praise the Lord. So today, tell your neighbor, wake up. If your neighbor does want to sleep and enjoy sleep, tell your neighbor, not in this service. Tell your neighbor, wake up. Holy Ghost, fire. Give him fire. Give him the fire of Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I said I had been learning about the mantle, and I didn't understand what it actually means. And why do they say mantle? Why mantle? Mantle simply is the power of God in a material or in a cloth. Say power of God in a material, in a cloth. When you put on this crown now, after I drop it here, you are conducting power. Amen. When you take my jacket and you touch it, you touch the helm, you are contacting what? Power. That handkerchief in your hand, wave it unto the Holy Ghost. Power. Say power. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Receive that power. Take it. Take it right now. Take it. Take it. Take it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive that power. Receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Receive the fire. Receive a touch. Receive it. Receive it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it now. Take it. Take it. Take that power. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive that power. Receive that power. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive that power. Receive that power. Receive it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take that power. Take that power. Take that power. Take that power. Take it in the name of Jesus. Take it in the name of Jesus. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive your freedom. Receive your freedom. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Take that power. Take that power. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive that power. Receive that power in the name of Jesus. Receive that power. He says it is the power of God in a cloth. So this is what you are set to conduct this morning. But it must have been prayed for. It must have been soaked. And it must have come into contact with a man of God. Why I put that one on you right now? It is because yours truly, I have conducted it from those that are of a higher anointing than me. So when I say, you stupid demon, shut up, I am speaking from a position of power and a position of authority. Because I know what I carry. I know the power that backs me. I know of the power where I taped that power. Praise Master Jesus. So when the man of God steps up this morning, you are set to receive your own portion in the name of Jesus. But why the mantle? This is why I want to round up quickly. Why the mantle? The book of 1 Kings, chapter 19. Praise the Lord. 1 Kings, chapter 19, verse 16. 1 Kings, chapter 19, verse 16. And Jehu, the son of Nimish, shalt thou anoint to be king over Israel. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Jehu, you shall anoint as what? As king over Israel. And Elisha, the son of Shaphat, of Abel Mahola, thou shalt anoint to be prophet in thy room. Elisha, shall you what? Anoint a prophet in thy room. Immediately, when people will start talking about anointing, what comes into mind? People will start talking about water. People will start talking about what? Oil. That is the anointing that we know. That is the anointing that we have been taught. But listen here. Verse 19. That 1 Kings, verse 19. 1 Kings 19, verse 19. So he departed thence and found Elisha, the son of Shaphat, who was plowing with what? With 12 yoke of oxen before him, and with the 12, and passed, and Elijah passed by him. Elijah passed by him. Elijah, let's talk to each other. Elijah, Elijah, and when it happened, he cast his mantle upon him. Say anointing! Say anointing! Say follow me. This is why this service is a special anointing service. Because God in his manifest wisdom, he says when you You need something which is tangible and visible that you carry with you everywhere and anywhere you go. Mantle. Mantle. Power in your pocket. When you put it there, you can begin to command that spirit of poverty working in your office to go. Say power. Power in the pocket. Power in my hands. Power above my head. Students, when you are studying and your head is getting to that stage where you are just seeing lines. Power. Say power. Business people, it looks like it's not happening in your business. Strike that door. Strike those products. Say power. By an anointing. He says, Elisha, anoint in the office of a prophet. By a what? By a mantle. By a mantle. So this is why this morning, in the beginning of the month, the Lord delivered for you anointing water, blood transfusion. But he says there is one more thing that my people need. Power. Power visible. Power they can carry. Power they can use. When it's difficult. A difficult interview. When the words are not coming. Power. When you say McDonald's, McDonald's in the interview. Suddenly they will say yes, 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 yes. This man knows what he's talking about. Hire this man. You are saying what? Nandos, 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 Nandos. In that interview. Power will answer for you. Power. This is why this morning the Lord has prepared a special vessel. But quickly, how do I conduct it? Is I round up. How do I conduct it? Number one, be expectant. That woman in the book of Mark with the issue of blood, she says, if I may touch, she expected. And when she touched Jesus, she received it. This morning, you are set to receive your own. Praise the Lord. What else? Obedience. Say obedience. Obedience to the command. When a word goes forth to say, bring a handkerchief, bring a handkerchief. 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 41 to verse 45. Hallelujah. 1 Kings chapter 18. Praise the Lord. You must be what? Obedient to what you are being told. And Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up, eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundant rain. Some of us have been told, come to Wednesday prayer warfare. There is a sign of open heaven. And we have stayed at the house. Thank God for Mama Mantla, ne? Where is she? Thank God for her, for telling you that when you come warfare on Wednesday, heavens open for you. The heavens will set to open for somebody in this month. To someone who is going to be obedient to come to the service, it's set to open for you. For someone the Lord is speaking to say, save me, the heavens are set to open for you. By what? By obedience. Verse 45. And it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with clouds and wind, and there was great heaven rain. Say, open heavens. Say, open heavens. Rain always signifies blessings. Rain always signifies growth. Rain always signifies favor. Receive that favor in your obedience in the name of Jesus. Number three, believe. Believe. Hallelujah. It says, these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out devils. Mark 16, verse 17 to 20. Then also believe in his servants. It's a popular scripture we hear again and again and again. And I will say it again. Believe in the Lord your God. Believe then you shall what? Be established. Then believe also in the prophets. A prophet is simply a man of God that speaks and declares over your life. Because some of you might say, my own prophet does not see vision, doesn't see what's happening tomorrow. It takes a special grace like our Father in the house. But if there is a man that prophesies and declares in your life, is also standing in the shoes of a what? Of a prophet. So when I declare, let there be breakthrough, I am standing in the shoes of a what? Of a prophet. Don't look at me and say, it's only Pastor Nick. The moment I am declaring, the moment I am saying it from the shoes and the office of a what? Of a prophet. So believe in the Lord your God, you shall be established. Believe also in the prophets. Then shall you what? Shall you prosper. You want open heavens? Believe in every word that comes forth from the altar. Praise the Lord. Lastly, it is by thanksgiving and by praise. You have a thanksgiving and a praiseful life. Be thankful in all things. Give what? Give thanks. Even if it's not working, even when the heavens are looking like they are shut, they are not happening, when you are saying, Eish, kimatata fela, give what? Give thanks. Give what? Give thanks. Because God has not forgotten about you. God has not abandoned you. The heavens are set to open. He says, if you shall pray, if you shall what? Pray towards my holy house, then I shall answer from where? From heaven. If you shall what? If you shall pray. Let's rise to our feet as we prepare for the servant of the Lord to come through. If you shall what? You shall pray. Before the servant of the Lord steps up, I was talking about expectation. Silence for a minute. What is it you want to conduct from that mantle this morning? What is it you want to conduct right now? Lift your voice as you begin to pray. As you begin to worship the Lord. Is it a business? Is it a job? Is it marriage? Is it healing? What is it the Lord must do to you via that mantle in your hand right now? Begin to speak unto the Lord. Close your eyes. Do not worry about your neighbor. Cry unto the Lord. Cry unto him. Father, my heavens must open. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. As your servant begins to declare, begins to minister, my heavens must open. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. For my business, my heavens must open. My career, my heavens must open. Begin to declare it right now. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. My ministry, my heavens must open. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. Lord, my health. My heavens must open. My ministry. My heavens must open. My heavens must open. Pray, 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 pray,